fail is a very dangerous word. Everything that is a failure is always a victory. Unlike the other writers who come here, I have not traveled very much. This is my first time in a foreign country where I speak none of the language, and where I so don't understand the language that it sounds like music to me. I can't tell where one word, and it doesn't stick in my brain very well. What I've, in many ways, I've been here a week, I am a failure at Italian. It's very difficult, and it's very, in many ways, humiliating to be in a country that isn't mine and to be reduced really to the status of a baby. People all around me are talking with great animation about things that I do. It's not like I don't totally understand. I don't understand at all what they're talking about. In order to have the simplest interaction, I'm, you know, hello, okay. Three, I mean, it's very, right? It's very humbling. One feels like a failure, yes? On the other hand, what I've noticed is it's also good in a very profound way. What I've noticed here is how very kind and patient the Italians here are when someone, I'm very conscious of the image of the ugly American who comes in and, where's the McDonald's? And why don't y'all speak English? And all that kind of, right? So I'm very, I've got none of those feelings from the Italians, and I've also noticed that I pay much more attention to people's faces and emotional cues, and that much like a child, I am sensitive and attuned to things that when I'm home and immersed in English, I'm living only linguistically, and like, oh yeah, three waters, hey, what is going to do? You know, it's all so fast. So it's painful to be here, but it's also good. Okay. In some ways, what I try to do with myself is just avoid the success or failure thing, because it really is much more, there's so much about writing that is out of the writer's control. Not the action of doing it, but whether it comes alive or not. That if I begin thinking in terms of failure, what happens is I get really depressed and the game is over because I've already decided. So that's all I know. It's a very long criticism of an innocuous question. Thing I think of as an American is individual identity. David. What makes David David? What makes David different from all the other people? It's very individual. I think the struggle for those of us in America is to conceive of our identity as part of something larger, something more meaningful than ourselves. There's very little support for that in our culture, in our economy, in our politics. But without it, the country splits apart, fragments, atomizes. So this is in America a very loaded word. I am now such a fan of Italy in the World Cup, but here's why, is that I think these phenomena feed on themselves. I had watched soccer matches a couple of times. I just don't understand it. But watching them, I got to watch, it wasn't even, I guess, a very good game, Italy versus Australia, with Antonio and Davide and some of their relatives, and Davide's throwing bottle caps and they're talking to each other. And the energy in the room was such that, you know, by the end, with the penalty kick, and you know, I still don't understand. Only the tiniest fragments. I understand that not everybody can be as hurt as they seem to be. That some of that is so that the referees will call. Yeah, a little bit. But watching it with people who care about it, it's like watching the Super Bowl in America, even if you don't care about football. What I would say to you, children now in America, because mothers don't want their children hurt, are playing much more, European world football than American football, and in a generation, you wait. Maybe not in my generation, but in the one following, football and world football, America will be more into it than you wish they were, because they will cheat and pour all this money into it, and it will become this is a prediction.